Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Lisa and today I'm going to be planning in my 7x9 Erin Condren compact vertical. I am using a beautiful sticker kit by Simply Smith Stickers. It is the first week in October and I've got fall vibes, so I'm definitely gravitating to fall colors. So during this video, it's going to be very, very chatty. Carol Ann and I signed a contract on a house. There have been a lot of questions. And while I'm putting down stickers, I'm going to answer all the questions because there have been some comments and concerns and some not so nice comments. And I'm just going to like clear the air while I am putting down stickers. So if you really want to know a lot about this home buying process and what we've been doing, this is the video for you. And you get to see some cute stickers too. So let's go ahead and start with the obvious. So we had originally wanted to do a brand new build. And when Carol Ann went to the model home and was talking to the gal about the new build and what all was gonna be included, we realize, and we didn't know this, I mean, we've never built a house before. Like, this is all brand spanking new for us. The lady said, well, you know, we only give you $5,000 for upgrades that you can put into the mortgage, and then everything else you got to come out of pocket. And we were like, what the actual bleepity bleep bleep bleep. So we realized really quickly that there was no way that we were going to get hardly anything that we wanted, because one thing that we didn't want was carpeting, and just to do the vinyl plank floors throughout, that upgrade was like $5,000, just that, before anything else was done. And when she came home and we were talking about it, it was just like, we're pumping the brakes on this. We just didn't feel good about it. We weren't going to get anything that we wanted. And, you know, quite honestly, I mean, Carol Ann, she liked that layout. And, I mean, I was fine with it. It wasn't like my dream. I wanted the two-story house. I wanted it from the beginning. And that was just, you know, what I wanted, because I really felt like the two-story house was going to give us the, you know, real independent space where I was going to have my own floor to do with what I want. And we would just, you know, have much more separation of space than to do a one story, but she really liked it. Oops, I did that upside down. So I was like, you know, I was willing to compromise. And another thing that I wasn't really like thrilled about was the fact that, you know, there was no flex space for an office, you know, and I was just going to have to use bedrooms to have all the spaces that I want. And I didn't really feel like it gave me the independence if she were to get married and, you know, have kids. I don't know. It just, you know, wasn't my dream house, but she loved it and I was willing to compromise because I love her. So, you know, after she got home and we realized it was just not, it just wasn't going to happen. It just, we were very disappointed. And you know, we were going to be locked into our lease until July because I signed a 2-year lease. Well, Carol Ann, I don't know how this even happened, but after she looked at all the things, the gal at the builder took her by the two-story house. And the story goes that, you know, the gal who built that house from scratch did a gazillion updates, and she couldn't sell her own home, and so she had to walk away from it, even after putting, you know, 20 some odd thousand dollars worth of upgrades into the house. And so when the build was just not gonna work out, I told Carol Ann, I said, well, we can just start really like saving our money into an upgrade fund. And then when we get to the amount of money that we need, then we can move forward. No big deal. But I was talking to the gals that I rent from, which they're my friends. You know, it's not like I'm renting from some stranger that, you know, it's just not like that. They are my friends. And I was talking to them about the whole thing, and I, you know, about the build and all that. And I was telling them about the two-story house. I said, but, you know, it's really not an option because we've got a lease. And she was like, girl, we love you. And if that is your dream home, go for it. Do it. And I was like, are you serious? She's like, we don't need the money for the rent. You know, they just don't. So I thought, okay. So I went ahead and went to go look at the house. I texted Caroline. I was like, man, it is perfect. And she's like, are you serious? And I was telling her that, you know, the gals we rented from said, you know, they gave their blessing, and it just kind of felt like it was meant to be. It has granite. It has most of the plank flooring. I mean, eventually we're going to have to, you know, replace the carpeting, because that wasn't really what we wanted. But y'all, everything else that we wanted is in this house. And I love the fact that it's two-story and I have my own space upstairs. You know, I've got a little microwave cart. I'm going to put a mini fridge upstairs. I am going to have a microwave. There's going to be, you know, the mini fridge Caroline has, she's going to give me, and it has its own little freezer. So, you know, I just really feel like this space is going to kind of check all the boxes and give me like my independence and separate space upstairs that I really wanted to begin with. Right now I'm just kind of putting down my to-dos. So I did my dates. This is kind of like all my chores that I like to do each day is what I'm doing right now. So this is like very, very exciting. Well, the interest rate, that was another. So I hope that answers all the questions about the concerns. Somebody mentioned, oh, well, that's not enough space for the fur babies. I don't know how you could say that, because we're in 1200 square feet right now. And the new house is 2,400 square feet. It is huge. And there is more than enough room for all of the fur babies. They are going to be in heaven. The backyard is definitely a little bit smaller than we would have liked. We would have liked a corner lot, but it's fine. We're going to fence the whole thing in, even the sides. And it'll give them enough room to run. We're gonna put an opening to the back because they're not gonna build behind us. That's just gonna be green space. So we'll be able to walk the dogs, there's sidewalks and all the things. So let's see, what was another question? Oh, well, we thought that you were gonna do in a brand new subdivision that didn't have any builds. Yes, we were. Yes, when we were going to do the new build from scratch. No, there's nothing in that subdivision yet. Hasn't even been started. This one obviously has been started. So there's that. There were a couple comments about us not being transparent on this channel about our finances, and I could not disagree more. I feel like I have been very transparent on this channel about my budget. Now, I probably could add some videos to go back and like go over like what I actually spent. I don't really do that, but I don't go into debt. I only spend what I have in cash. And so if I do overspend, it just comes from something else. Like maybe I don't do a sinking fund one month. And here lately we've just been, you know, putting money into savings like crazy. So I did cash out my CDs so that everything is in cash. So we will be ready to go when we close. I won't get the full amount, of course, of interest because I cashed out the CDs, but that's okay. I'm all right with that. I really did CDs mainly so that I wouldn't touch the money. So right now, Caroline and I have a joint account where we have our money for the house. That has $15,000 in it. My emergency fund needs some work because I think I only have about $5,500 in it right now. I transferred a little bit too much over to the house savings, which is fine. I got a plan for that. So I'll be contributing like $500 a month to my own personal emergency fund after we get moved in. We have 4.99% interest rate on our loan. The HOA is under $200 a year. I'm trying to think if there was any other questions or concerns from folks. I probably shouldn't like pay too much attention to the negative, you know, comments, but it really, you know, it just kind of flies all over me because I really feel like I have been transparent and, you know, kind of like taking you guys along on the journey. And I just hadn't had a chance yet to fill you guys in on what happened, but I didn't want to like keep the news to myself. So I posted it. But, you know, there are a lot of channels on YouTube, and, you know, if this one isn't the one for you, I get it. I totally get it. But, you know, what I'm not going to do is, like, justify my decisions. Like, I have worked really hard to get out of debt. I've worked really hard to save my money. And this is, like, the most exciting thing that has happened in my life in a really long time, and I'm just not going to... I'm deleting any negative comments. I'll just say it up front. I'm not even, I did respond to one and then I thought, you know what? Screw this. I just am not in the mood and I removed it. So I hope that you know, I've answered all of your questions about, you know, why we jumped on this property and why, you know, things kind of happened quickly. Like it just did. You know, and it's our dream house. It has the half bath I wanted for guests. You know, the grandkids and I are going to hang out upstairs while, you know, Carolyn and her significant other are downstairs. And that is A-okay with me. I'm going to have a living room space, an office space, one bedroom, and then there's two spare bedrooms. Okay. If you guys have any other questions, you know, I'm happy to answer them. You can leave those down in the comments. Carolyn and I were working last night on our, I'm putting down a tracker for my weight. I'm doing semaglutide. And I'm tracking my weight. I want to say I'm at 221 and I started out at 230. So I'm definitely making a whole bunch of progress. Okay, we got our to-dos down, we got our dates, we tracking our weight. See, Saturday is coffee with my parents. Let me write that down. Yeah, I don't respond well to negativity, quite honestly. It's, you know, maybe I should be a little bit more tolerant, but I'm just not. Especially, you know, when it's like, oh, I hope you don't mind. And then, you know, there's negativity and then people comment on that and like, yeah, you know, we don't da 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 da. And I'm like, bye. I mean, it's not like we're making like a gazillion dollars doing this on YouTube, you know? I think, This last month, we got $300 that went into house savings. This month, we're going to have another $300 probably in YouTube income. So this is not my bread and butter. I have a regular job and a part-time job that I'm working, plus doing YouTube to try to like save money for this house. So there's that. Let's see. What else do I have? Trash. I was going to do these kinds of pretty script stickers, but I think I'm only going to do a couple and then do the rest and we'll do some deco. Ooh, weekend. I usually use this one, but I'm here for it. Weekend. Yeah, I don't know what other channels do about negativity, but it, I just, I can't. I just cannot. I can't. Okay, so I'm not going to use any of these, but I am going to use, I have a committee meeting on Sunday, and I have a 6 o'clock meeting on Thursday I gotta go to, which reminds me, I got somewhere to be at noon today. 2:46, and then I work in kind of like tech support, and I like to track my tickets. I like to know how many tickets I've been, I start out the day with. Of course, it fluctuates, because then during the day I'm taking more tickets, and it goes up, it goes down, but it always is nice for me to know how many I'm starting out with. Anyhoodle, so all that to say, like rant over, I guess. You know, I do appreciate you guys a lot. I appreciate you guys watching my channel and supporting us. And, you know, we share as much as we can. I mean, honestly, a lot of it is, God, we're just so dang busy. And, you know, it's hard to come back and do check-ins. You know, as far as like our spending and stuff, we, or at least I am pretty on budget most months. I mean, I spend my spending money, but aside from that, I don't really spend a whole lot of money. I am gonna cancel my gym membership. I'll probably go up there today and do that. And I'm canceling Hulu because, I mean, I don't ever watch it. My parents watch it, and my mom was like, Dad can pay for it. So I'm going to go ahead and cancel that. So that's going to save me quite a bit of money. So that is going to be a thing this week. I'm going to get that done today. So that's not going to be on my budget anymore. What do I have coming up for you guys? Carol Ann and I were working on the budgets. We did two budgets. So one is when, you know, we are paying half of all of the bills. And then we're going to do a separate budget where we are doing all of the bills independently. So my daughter and I are best friends. And we have been living together for several years. We don't fight. We don't argue. We don't bicker. We just get along really, really well. And, you know, will there maybe be some times when she gets on my dang nerves? Abso-freaking-lutely. But we really have a very easy relationship. And so I am not concerned about buying a house with her. We're doing it jointly. If I croak, she gets the house. If she croaks, I get the house. It, you know, we really have everything just kind of, you know, figured out and what's going to work for us. If it didn't work for you, if it wouldn't work for you, totally understand. It doesn't need to work for you. It just needs to work for us. So keep that in mind, you know, when sharing opinions. It just, I totally get it. If you and your daughter don't get along, or you don't have, you know, you could never live with your kids. I get it. I get it. Totally. You know, not everybody could. Me, I love it. She comes to me every morning with a brush in her hand to do her hair. Like she's my bestie. And so is my mom. I could live with my mom too. No doubt about it. So not for you. Totally understand. Okay. We're putting pumpkins everywhere, guys. Pumpkin. Gosh, I'm trying to think if there were any other questions that I really needed to address. I mean, most of the comments have been really nice and, you know, considerate and excited for us. And I love those comments. You guys make my day. I love answering your questions and reading your comments. Carol Ann and I read them together. She has the Creator app on her phone too. And so we're both reading and responding. So we were going over them the other night, but I'm excited. But, you know, if there's some more transparency that you guys want, I will definitely, you know, try to do some check-in so you guys know exactly what I'm spending my money on. But, typically I'm just kind of like on budget and, you know, maybe I don't save as much some paychecks because, you know, I might go a little bit over. But for the most part, I'm pretty much on budget. Anyway, I love you guys. I do. I appreciate you so much. And I hope that, you know, I've answered all of your questions and addressed any concerns and like why it was so rushed and why we're doing this and why we're doing that. You know, it just kind of like when things just kind of like unfold and happen and it feels right and I've been preparing and I've been saving my money, like, why wouldn't we move forward? We feel good about it. We're excited about it. We have no reservations, no concerns. We are just loosey-goosey, excited, ecstatic, making so many plans. And I can't wait to like bring you guys along in the ride. All right, guys, again, love you bunches. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for supporting this channel. And I hope you guys have a great day or night, wherever you're at. Bye.